In this video, I am going to explain the design of CMOS NAND gate. So, first of all, if you see the operation of CMOS NAND gate, so the functionality of any gate or any logic circuit can be expressed by using truth table. So, the truth table for NAND gate is, let us assume the inputs are AB and the output is Y. Then the NAND gate output is when at least one of the input is 0, output is 1, and when all the inputs are 1, then the output is 0. This is the functionality. Okay, from this that the logic function for NAND gate is Y is equal to A dot B whole bar. And the logic symbol for NAND gate is two input NAND gate is this is the NAND gate with the inputs A, B, output Y. Y is equal to A dot B whole bar. So now we have to implement this logic function. Y is equal to A dot B whole bar. Okay. So there are a number of steps to implement this. So the first one is the logic function must be in whole complemented form. Okay, here the logic function has whole complemented. Okay, second one, we need to identify how many number of transistors required. So to implement two input NAND gate, it needs two NMOS transistors and two PMOS transistors. And the third point is, so these NMOS and PMOS transistors can be used to implement pull down and pull up networks of CMOS logic circuit. So every CMOS logic circuit consists of one pull up network PUN, pull up network, and one pull down network. So pull up network is implemented by using only PMOS transistors, and pull down can be implemented with only NMOS transistors. Okay, fourth one. Now the logic function is Y is equal to A dot B whole bar. How to implement this? So here it which is in whole complemented form, and it has two input variables, so it needs two NMOS transistors and two PMOS transistors. Okay, so those two NMOS transistors are connected in series, because between those two variables there is a dot operation. Okay, whenever we have dot between the variables, then NMOS transistors must be connected in series, PMOS transistors must be connected in parallel. So this is the logic to implement any logic function. So let us see NMOS and PMOS transistors. This is the symbol for NMOS transistor and it has three terminals. Generally for NMOS transistor, source is shown at the bottom, okay, bottom side, and a drain is at upper side, because generally in NMOS transistor, drain is at higher potential than source. Similarly, in PMOS transistor, source is at upper higher potential and drain is at lower potential. Then next one is schematic diagram. How can you draw the schematic diagram for this CMOS NAND gate? So it has two networks, pull up network and pull down network. First of all, we'll implement pull down network. In the pull down network, the NMOS transistors must be connected in series. NMOS transistors must be connected in series. So let us consider two NMOS transistors. These two must be connected in series. So this is the source terminal, drain, source, drain. And PMOS transistors must be connected in parallel. So this is the PMOS transistors. Okay. This is the first input A and it is the second input. And between these two, we can take the output. And these are the source terminals and drain terminals of PMOS transistors, sources and drains. So the sixth point is function table. We have to verify the functionality of this schematic diagram. Okay, so the function table consists of inputs and the transistors and output. So for the given inputs 00, okay, so for 00, these PMOS transistors, both the PMOS transistors, coming to PMOS transistor, when in equal to 0, then PMOS transistor is in on state. For when we in equal to 1, input equal to 1, which is in off state. Coming to NMOS transistor, when the input is 0, NMOS is in off state, and when the input is 1, NMOS transistor is in on state. Okay, by considering this operation, when input equal to 00, A and B inputs are 00, the PMOS transistors Q3 and Q4 are in on state, and the NMOS transistors Q1 and Q2 are in off state. So Q1, Q2 off, Q3, Q4 on. So if you see here, Q3 and Q4, both the transistors are in on state. So there is a path from VDD to output. output through Q4 or Q3. Okay, so the output is 1, and the second case, one of the input is 0 here. So the corresponding transistor is in on state, either Q3 or Q4. Then it provides a low resistance path from VDD to output. So again the output is 1. And the last case, when both the inputs are 1. When the input is 1, what about NMOS transistor? NMOS transistor is in on state. So only when both the NMOS transistors are in on state, then only it provides a path from output to ground. So when the inputs are 1 1, these two transistors Q1 and Q2 is in on state, and it provides a path from output to ground. So the output becomes 0. These are the steps you must follow to design any logic function. If this video is useful, please share your suggestions. Based on your suggestions, I'll make my future videos. Thank you.